Welcome back to Cunning Quizzes. Are you ready to embark on a journey through the wonders of science? From cells to celestial bodies, we've got 30 subatomically sublime questions lined up. So, grab your thinking caps and a pen and paper to record your scores, and let's get going. Proceed. Okay, let's start with some astronomy. What star is closest to the sun? 61 Cygni, Andromeda, or Proxima Centauri? That's right, it's Proxima Centauri. It's about 4.2 light years away, or about 40 trillion kilometers. So, not that far. Okay, paleontology now. Question 2. How far back in time does the fossil record go? 3.5 billion years, 500 million years, or 67 million years? What do you think? It goes back 3.5 billion years! The earliest fossils discovered are structures known as stromatolites, created by microorganisms. Types of substances now. Question 3. What is concrete? A mixture, an emulsion, or a solution? It's a mixture. Yes, this is because the component substances maintain their own chemical identities. Okay, biology now. Question 4. Who introduced the binomial nomenclature system for naming species? Linnaeus, Darwin, or Mendel? Yes, this naming system was invented by the Swedish botanist Carl Linnaeus in 1753. Okay, we got the moon now. Question 5. How long does it take for the moon to complete one rotation on its axis? 1 day, 28 days, or 365 days? It's 28 days! Because the moon has a locked orbit around Earth, one spin on its axis is also one orbit around Earth. So, there we are then. Right, the human body is next. Question 6. How many human cells are there in the human body? 3 trillion, 30 trillion, or 300 trillion? Have a guess. There are 30 trillion cells in the human body. There are other non-human cells in the human body, such as bacteria in the gut. Okay, chemistry now. Question 7. Who formulated the law of conservation of mass? Linus Pauling, Marie Curie, or Antoine Lavoisier? It was Lavoisier. He stated that in chemical reactions, nothing is lost, nothing is created, everything is transformed. Right, keeping with chemistry. Question 8. What is ammonium hydroxide? Salt, acid, or base? The clue's in the name. It's a base. You find it in cleaning products and fertilizers. When it's concentrated, it can burn the skin. Pretty nasty stuff. Okay, how's your knowledge of scalar quantities? Question 9. Which of the following is a scalar quantity? Force, mass, or momentum? Yep, it's mass. A scalar quantity is any quantity that we can describe by only its magnitude. The other options here also require a direction. Okay, jolly good. We've got dinosaurs next. Question 10. In which geological era did dinosaurs inhabit the Earth? The Mesozoic, the Cenozoic, or the Paleozoic? They existed during the Mesozoic era. This era is divided into the Triassic, Jurassic, and Cretaceous periods. Okay, a question about scientists now. Question 11. Who proposed the first atomic model? Thomson, Rutherford, or Dalton?
Hmm? That's right, John Dalton proposed the first atomic model back in 1803. He theorized that all matter is composed of tiny particles called atoms. Right, electricity is next. Question 12. What is measured in ohms? Electrical potential, electrical resistance, or electrical current? Any idea? It's electrical resistance. Yes, electrical resistance decreases in cooler materials, and this is why we typically see superconductors in a cloud of liquid nitrogen. Well, we don't usually see them, we see pictures of them. Okay, genetics now. Question 13. What binds DNA helices to each other? The covalent bond, the hydrogen bond, or the ionic bond? Do you know? It's the hydrogen bond. It's often compared to a zipper, where the teeth are the base pairs and the hydrogen bonds are the links holding them together, apparently. Okay, here's a fun one. Question 14. Which acoustic phenomenon can shatter glass? Reverberation, diffraction, or resonance? It's resonance. Resonance isn't just opera singers shattering glass with their voices. The Tacoma Narrows Bridge in Washington State famously collapsed in 1940 due to resonance caused by the wind. Blimey. Right, Newton is next. Question 15. Which of Newton's laws of motion state that for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction? The first, the second, or the third? Do you remember from school? It's the third law. It means that if one body exerts a force on a second body, the second body exerts an equal and opposite force on the first body. Okay, we're going to look at radiation now. Question 16. Which type of radiation can be stopped with just a sheet of paper? Alpha, beta, or gamma? Yes, it's alpha radiation. Their particles are so big, they cannot penetrate paper. Right. Okay, a human body question is up next. Question 17. Which type of cell produces antibodies? B cells, T cells, or natural killers? It's the B cells! All these types of cells are involved in the body's immune system, but only the B cells produce antibodies. In case you're wondering, the ominous-sounding natural killers produce a toxin that is harmful to viruses and cancer cells. Good on them. Okay, another question about scientists now. Question 18. Who proposed that a planet's orbit is an ellipse? Archimedes, Newton, or Kepler? Hmm? It was Johannes Kepler. This idea formed part of his three laws of planetary motion, published between 1609 and 1619. The periodic table is up next. Question 19. In which group of the periodic table does oxygen belong? Group 11, 16, or 18? It's in group 16. This group, also known as the chalcogens, comprises oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, polonium, and livermorium. The last one, livermorium, was created by American and Russian scientists back in the early 2000s. Oh, that's nice. Okay, botany is next. Question 20. Which plant does not produce pollen? Pine, fennel, or fern? Any idea? Yes, it's the fern plant. It reproduces through spores. Another kind of plant which doesn't produce pollen is moss. Okay, types of energy now. Question 21. What type of energy does a body possess due to its position relative to others? Thermic, potential, or kinetic? Yeah. Yes, it's potential energy. This energy is stored within an object and can be converted into other forms of energy when the object's position changes. Right, a question about biologists now. Question 22. Who first discovered microorganisms? Robert Koch, Robert Hooke, or Leeuwenhoek? I'm sure I've butchered that name. They were first discovered by Antony van Leeuwenhoek in the 1670s. He's widely regarded as the father of microbiology. Right. Okay, you're going to need to use some mathematics now. Question 23. How many years, roughly, does it take for 75% of carbon-14 to decay? 11,400, 8,550, or 5,700 years? Can you work this out? It takes 11,400 years. Right, so after one half-life of 5,730 years, 50% of the carbon-14 remains. So after two half-lives of 11,460 years, 25% remains, meaning 75% has decayed. Okay, let's see if you can remember this from high school. Question 24. What increases in an isolated system undergoing spontaneous evolution? Heat, entropy, or speed? It's entropy! Yes, this is according to the second law of thermodynamics. Right, evolution now. Question 25. In vertebrates, which bone evolved into the jaw? The cranial bones, the vertebrae, or the gill arches? Do you know? Yes, the jawbone evolved from gill arches found in fish. Makes a lot of sense if you think about it. We've got the laws of physics coming up now. Question 26. What law of physics makes a hydraulic press work? Hubble's law, Pascal's law, or Archimedes' principle? Any idea? That's right, it's Pascal's law. This states that any pressure applied to an enclosed liquid is transmitted throughout the liquid in all directions. Okay, so what do you know about early plastic? Question 27. What challenge did early plastic objects face? They could explode, they were sensitive to chemicals, or they were too expensive. Did you hear about this? Yes, they could actually explode. One of the first types of plastic, celluloid, was used to make billiard balls and films. A unique danger for billiard players was that the balls could sometimes explode when they were hit. Well, that would certainly make a game of pool more interesting. Okay, it's time for an Einstein question now. Question 28. What is the central hypothesis in Einstein's general relativity? The universe has been expanding since the Big Bang, dark matter affects galaxy structure, or gravitation has deformed space-time? Yes, gravitation has deformed space-time. In his theory of general relativity, Einstein predicted phenomena such as black holes and gravitational waves. Yeah, clever guy. Nobel Prize winners next. Question 29. What earned Charpentier and Doudna the Nobel Prize in 2020? A method for DNA editing, the discovery of the Higgs boson particle, or the development of blue LEDs? Yes, they won it for developing a precise method to edit DNA. With their invention, called CRISPR-Cas9, they revolutionized genetic research. Okay, we're going to finish with a botany question. This is a hard one. Question 30. What plant hormone is used to create seedless fruits? Ethylene, auxin, or gibberellin? Sounds like gibberish. Do you have any idea? It's auxin. This is a hormone that is normally released by the seeds and triggers the development of fruit. So, now you know. Okay, how did you get on? Let us know in the comments. If you enjoyed this quiz, then maybe think about subscribing so you'll be in the loop for when the next one comes out. Thank you so much for watching. Cheerio.